Hi, Jeff. How are you? My Percy, who has been leash reactive before, had a training session today. He walked perfectly, didn't growl or bark at any passerby or dogs, even behaved at a restaurant. So proud.
Awesome. I'm so proud of you. That means you're working hard. Anybody that gets starting to get results from their dog is because they're busting their fucking ass. I don't believe in luck. It's not luck. It's not a miracle. It's called hard work. Like we're rehabbing this dog, Max. If you follow the story about Max, like, nobody's prayers have been answered. Not being disrespectful here to people that pray. No miracle. Not being disrespectful to people that believe in miracles. Okay? The reason why Max is doing well, because hard work from my staff. That's 100% of it. There's no other reason why. Hard work and dedication from my staff. And people need to know why. Because of their tireless work to make sure there was only one option, and that was success. All my staff, from my trainers all the way down, because they all work with the dogs there. Every single staff member has interacted with Max. Every single staff member is killing it with that dog. That is why that dog is good. So the praying didn't work. Miracles didn't work. Hope didn't work. Goddamn good fucking dog training and behavior modification is working.
Woo!
I'm not angry. I'm fucking proud as hell of my staff. Hell yeah. And people need to know why. That people need to know why. Where everybody else has failed, why we're successful on that. I'm sorry. But that's a fucking dog nobody would work with. Nobody. I know it. That dog wouldn't last one night in 99.99% of dog trainers' homes or facilities. One night. I know that. Next.
Ooh, feeling pumped.
We're live on this channel right now. So now we're live. But we'll see how it looks. Okay, so we're back here to a new show.
Okay, here I am.
And let me see if we have sound. Check for sound. Hey guys, how are you? Sorry about the mishap.
Yeah.
Yep. So we're out. We obviously don't have good internet service here. So the show we were doing all of a sudden got disconnected, and I couldn't get back on it. I couldn't get back on it at all. So the way you have to do it is I had to start a brand new show. This is the brand new show. So sorry about the confusion. So we'll delete that one. So all your questions that were asked, I didn't hear. So I'm not quite sure what will happen to this show either if our internet connection still is weak. So, but anyway, thank you all for jumping on the second show. Okay, round.
I don't think anyone's here yet.
round two. So yeah. So start asking your dog training questions. It'll take a little bit of time for folks to get here. But in the meantime, let me just give you a quick intro. My name is Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training. I've got a dog training company up in Providence, Rhode Island. And what we are is we specialize in a lot of behavior modification, a lot of aggression rehab. We work with some pretty badly behaved dogs. Obviously, we also do obedience, all right, basic obedience, on leash and off leash. We actually are starting a whole huge puppy program. Wait until you see our huge 2,500 square foot puppy room that we'll be building. And it's going to be not only just for puppies, but like puppies will be able to utilize it, but also all dogs will be able to utilize it for confidence building. So we're building this whole new room with just all puppy stuff to build confidence in puppies. It'll be great for socialization. It'll be great for lots and lots of stuff. So that's happening, and that's exciting. What else? Right now we are in Elkhart, Indiana. Today is day one of our seminar in Elkhart. You go to jeffgellmanseminars.com. Joelle and I travel around the world doing dog training seminars. This year we're doing 25 of them. It's the largest pet dog seminar in the United States. This is a time for you to ask your questions. So what you'll do is you'll ask your questions, and where it says say something, we will answer them. And a lot of these answers, questions need like really long answers. Most of these need board and trains, or at least one-on-ones. And I also offer Skype. So I'm not doing this so people Skype with me, but Skype is an option, and you can go to our website, solidcaninetraining.com. And you can go to the Skype tab. You actually can purchase a Skype right off of our shopping cart, because I do so many Skypes. I Skype daily with three or four different people from around the world. So here we go. Also, a lot of folks are asking questions, which are how to stop an unwanted behavior. The only way to stop an unwanted behavior is through properly applied punishment. Punishment is not abuse. You're not upset. There's no yelling. There's no screaming. You're not mad. You're not angry. You're not upset with your dog. It's just, you can't do that. And let me apply a punisher. In order to increase the behavior of a dog, we use rewards. In order to decrease, eliminate, extinguish a behavior of a dog, we use punishment. Guys, this is really simple, common sense stuff. And most dog trainers out there either are lying to you or they just don't know. But most of them are lying to you. Because why? They don't want you to hate them. That's why. They're afraid of all the feedback. They're afraid from all of the pushback from all the hate. They're afraid to admit what they're doing, or they're not doing it and they're lying and they're trying to convince you that if you reward the dog enough, that you'll change the dog's behavior, stop its behavior. That's an outright blatant lie. It's unethical. It doesn't happen. We stop behaviors in seconds. Seconds we stop unwanted behaviors. And people have been struggling for years. So here we go. Joelle, let's do it.
Here we go. Nicole. Okay. How do I stop random growling? My dog growls at random things every once in a while. I punish with bonker, but he hasn't stopped.
I would use the remote collar and just say no and apply the punisher. Also, I mean, I need a little bit more context. Like, is the dog uncomfortable with stuff? You've got to advocate for your dog. So is it grumbling or is it a growl? Are people putting too much pressure on the dog? Most growling is not acceptable. Most growling is not acceptable. But if it's random, you should have a remote collar on the dog so you can say no and apply the punisher. But I would need a little bit more context because I don't believe that every dog should put up with anything. Meaning if a kid tries to pet it and it's petting it and the dog is growling, well, yes, we could correct that. But also we can say, hey, kid, stop petting the dog. Or if people are trying to pet the dog is backing up and it's growling. It's like, sure, we want to correct that, but also advocate for your dog and be like, hey, don't pet my dog. So we have to do both. We've got to do both. Advocate for the dog and then also correct the behavior. And then we can work the dog into up to more comfortable positions. Next.
Marvelous Maker. Yay, got connection.
Yeah, that's what Marvelous Maker. I was saying, yay, we got a connection. Next.
Kurt, working obedience and duration.
Food, it's not nervous. So you can do it. If a dog's not taking food, it's like a lot of nervous dogs won't take food. But if that dog's taking food, it's not that nervous. Next.
Ryan, hi, love y'all. What are the commands a pack of dogs should know prior to being able to feed them together like you do on Instagram? Concerned about resource guarding and stealing.
Ryan, I don't advise anybody to feed your dogs like you saw me feed my dogs last night. I don't encourage anybody to do that. I encourage everybody to feed your dogs in their crates. It takes them 30 seconds to eat. It's one and done. In my RV, I have a brand new RV. I have decided I'm not, and I feed raw. So I've got raw. So it's like raw beef, raw pork, raw kidneys, raw hearts, raw liver. I've got like,
get it.
I've got duck heads.
All raw.
I've got like lots of freaking organs and lots of raw stuff in there. Okay. I have decided dogs are not eating in my RV. So what do? I put them all outside, and there's a video on my Instagram stories, and I feed them, you know, a few, you know, like a meter or two apart. It's not commands, though. You're not using commands. That's going to be a relationship-based training protocol with your dogs knowing that they don't fuck with each other or someone will kick their ass. So my dogs know not to do it, and I don't give them any commands to do it. It's innate. They know not to do it. I don't encourage anybody to do that. Next.
Judy, I did it. I walked Dickens around the block today. Remember
Holy
him?
Shit, Judy, of Whoa! Course.
First time in 6 months, I walked like George Jefferson. Wisconsin seminar changed my life.
And you changed your screen name too.
She did.
Yeah, it's about time we know. We saw you as
What was it
Jay
before?
Schwartz.
It was something like not even related to her.
I don't know. I don't know. Cougar loves young men. I don't know. Next.
Oh. Melissa says, hello, Jeff and Joelle.
Hey, Melissa, how are you?
Hey, Melissa.
Melissa, can you delete the last show, hon? Thanks.
I also have to email her LinkedIn stuff.
I'll get you the LinkedIn information tonight. Thank you.
Scarlett, Raina is a recovering leash reactive dog. What are the next steps in teaching her what to do now that she goes into default avoidance when other dogs are around? Thanks for everything.
That's not the worst thing. Now what I want you to do is start getting your dog to walk amongst dogs by keeping dogs away from your dog. So keep your dog in a proper heel, get your dog with low environmentals of other dogs, and work your dog then eventually into high situations. But you still have to advocate for your dog. Like, I'm not expecting dogs to be able to walk right up to your dog, especially from the front, and your dog to deal with that right now. The side can be fine, but also then start moving your dog away from pressure. So a dog comes up, sniff, sniff, move your dog away. Next.
Scaredy floof. Yay, I finally made it to Alive.
Awesome. I know. We made it hard for you tonight. Next.
Zinc21 says hello.
Hey, Zinc21. How are you? How's the rest of the shit? What that thing's called? The scientific chart?
The periodic table of elements.
How's the rest of your buddies doing? Next.
Kaylee J. Hey, Jeff and Joelle. Loving all the updates on Max. Hoping the Elkhart seminar is going well. Much love to you both.
Elkhart is going fantastic. We're having a great time out here. And then we're home for...
a week?
Eight days.
Oh, okay. 8 days, not seven.
And you have one of those days off.
Yep.
Okay, so?
One whole day. No, I'm just going to take Tuesday, too.
What?
Are you serious?
Are you serious?
Okay.
Yeah, you get Monday off.
God.
Next.
Surprised you're giving me that.
It's your birthday.
It is my birthday. You're against people taking their birthdays off.
Yeah, but
it happens to fall on my day off.
Thank you. Oh, if you're
not taking it off.
No, I understand that. If your birthday was on a day that you had to work, you don't get your birthday off.
Shit.
You're not goddamn 12 years old.
I would not request it.
Nothing. I can't. Well, guys, don't stop taking your birthdays off of work. Give me a break. You're not 12. Next.
Daniel, dog is fine in crate when leaving for work, but any other time barks nonstop in crate. Bark collar did nothing.
Then you didn't use the right bark collar. Bark collars are wonderful. So your bark collar was not on properly. It wasn't a good brand, but the bark collar should do something. Next. I'm sorry. So get the Garmin bark limiter or the e-collar technology's ultra-sensitive bark collar. Make sure it's on proper fit. Snug on your dog. And make sure it's set right. It should do something. Put it on the dog, go outside, knock on the door. If your dog barks and makes a little bit of a yip or a yell, it's like, it's working. If your dog keeps barking, it's not on right. It's not on right. But bark collars are fantastic tools. Next.
Hallie, my dog has bad anxiety surrounding loud, sudden noises. It makes him bolt and hide somewhere with his tail between his legs.
Mm-hmm.
Recently, I found that it's very bad with thunder. Is this fixable?
Yeah, it's fixable. First thing you do is keep the dog on a leash. Don't let the dog bolt. So take away the act of fleeing because it's dangerous to do and have the dog go and lie down on a mat. Now, you're not using alternative behavior to fix that, but what you're doing is you just have to reinforce the down or reinforce the place. So over time, the dog will eventually then learn to relax. Next.
Aunt Girl 89. Hi, Jeff. How are you? My Percy, who has been leash reactive before, had a training session today. He walked perfectly, didn't growl or bark at any passerby or dogs, even behaved at a restaurant. So proud.
Awesome. I'm so proud of you. That means you're working hard. Anybody that is starting to get results from their dog is because they're busting their fucking ass. I don't believe in luck. It's not luck. It's not a miracle. It's called hard work. Like we're rehabbing this dog, Max. If you follow the story about Max, like, nobody's prayers have been answered. Not being disrespectful here to people that pray. No miracle. Not being disrespectful to people that believe in miracles. Okay? The reason why Max is doing well, because hard work from my staff. That's 100% of it. There's no other reason why. Hard work and dedication from my staff. And people need to know why. Because of their tireless work to make sure there was only one option, and that was success. All my staff, from my trainers all the way down, because they all work with the dogs there. Every single staff member has interacted with Max. Every single staff member is killing it with that dog. That is why that dog is good. So the praying didn't work. Miracles didn't work. Hope didn't work. Goddamn good fucking dog training and behavior modification is working.
Woo!
I'm not angry. I'm fucking proud as hell of my staff.
Hell yeah.
And people need to know why. People need to know why. Where everybody else has failed, why we're successful on that. I'm sorry. But that's a fucking dog nobody would work with. Nobody. I know it. That dog wouldn't last one night in 99.99% of dog trainers' homes or facilities. One night. I know that. Next.
Woo! Feeling pumped.
Cool. That's the next question.
Zinc21. My Corso is highly reactive only to other dogs. Should I try an e-collar?
Yeah, I mean, only, what do you mean only to other dogs? That's like, that's leash reactivity. That's a huge thing. That's why you want to ask the question. So it's not just the e-collar. So you have to know how to use it. The first thing you want to do is start recognizing signs of leash reactivity and then start eliminating that arousal. So that's what you want to do. So first of all, you want to make sure your dog's in a proper heel next to you. Get your dog to heel next to you and make sure it's in a relaxed state. It's not on alert. It's not on alert. Because if you just have your dog out in front of you or if it's on a harness, it ain't going to work on a harness. So keep the dog next to you, prong collar on the dog, proper heel, get the dog to be walking proper, no pulling. Make sure it's a nice loose leash. Learn how to do that first, then move to your remote collar. Okay, next.
Megan Reynolds, when you have a lot of board and trained dogs, do you have even the dogs who aren't great at place out back tied? I'd like to have more out, but some whine and others get off and I have to correct them. I do have the good ones out though.
So, well, the well-behaved ones out. So what I want you to do is, if you're talking about your own training facility, yes, we do. We get all the dogs out. But what's your skill set? It's a safety issue, right? So you got skill set of you, the skill set of the dogs that you've got, where they are in the rehab process, in the training process, and then your comfort level. And if shit goes bad, you're responsible. So what's the backup plan? You have a lot of safety. So back ties are great for that. Next.
Susan, do you ever recommend rehoming because the owner cannot commit to the structure the dog needs?
That's not why we would recommend rehoming. But I have recommended, most dogs that we get, rehoming is not an option. Rehoming is not an option. We get a lot of dogs that if we can't help them, then the dog gets put down. So we take our job very, very seriously. So some dogs, don't do well in a certain home, but I believe that we can make just about any dog work. But if we don't, we probably wouldn't take that on as a client, because I know it's not fair to the owner. So I won't work with a client if I don't think the end result, and I don't worry about being successful, because we're not successful all the time. We have dogs that just don't meet the level of expectation needed to stay alive. And it's not because of bad dog training, it's because like genetics and dog do play a role. Sorry, but all these people out there that think that every dog can be like this awesome dog is misinformed. No, it can't. I'm never going to play NBA basketball. I'm not going to. I don't care how bad I want it or who my coach is. I'm not going to do it. It's not in my DNA. It's not in my genetics. Just because I want to do it and just because somebody can afford the coach, that doesn't mean I'm going to be able to do that. So some dogs, though, if an owner comes to us and they're level of expectation is unrealistic to their lifestyle or what they have, I'd be like, why are you spending money on all this training? Because it's not going to work out. Next.
Aunt Girl 89 says she's been recording her dog's progress on IG.
Awesome. Proud of you.
Ginger Beaches of Hawaii. Thank you guys so much for what you do. My 8-month-old is doing great half hour downstays. Wow. If I put her into place, is it okay for my wife to give her the break command?
Yes, definitely. Try to work on longer downstays. We'll be in Oahu on the North Shore in November. We'll be in Oahu. Go to jeffgellmanseminars.com, jeffgellmanseminars.com. Join us. Next.
Michelle, yay, found take two link. Good evening, Jeff and Joel. Hope Elkhart is treating you well.
Elkhart is treating us well. We went out.
Weather's quite lovely.
We went out to a dinner tonight, just a quick dinner, the two of us. Came back here. After this, we'll probably go through a little bit of social update. I got about, I don't know, 50 YouTube comments that I've got to go through and respond to. We've got YouTube comments I've got to do. You've been keeping up pretty well with the comments on social. Because when I work a seminar, it's hard for me to keep up with comments. So we've got three platforms we have to keep up with comments. We like to respond to as many people as possible. At a minimum, like their comments. We have to get rid of some nonsense that people put up there. Obviously, that's all part of the gig. And then we have our normal social that we've got to do. Like keep up to date with the seminar stuff, too. So, next.
Maureen, started remote collar training with my very stubborn 13-month-old Labrador 3 days ago. Excellent, but he's already figured out that when the collar's off, he can slack.
Okay, so So 3 days ago, that collar should be on when you wake up, and it should come off when you go to sleep. Got it? Training is round the clock, technically. So training is all day long. But it's not just about the collar. What's the day look like? How demanding are you are of your dog? Are you letting your dog have too much freedom? Does the dog sleep in the crate? Are you cutting down on affection? All right, everything. Next.
Christina, thank you, Jeff. I finally put the prong collar on my dog, and it's been 2 days, and she hasn't pulled. I can walk her with a loose leash. She's not perfect, but we'll get there. Yeah, love you guys.
Don't worry about perfect. It's about fucking time, Christina. What are you waiting for? Good, I'm glad. If people are struggling on their walk, and you're not using a prong collar, get a prong collar. Like, I mean, like, let's just, guys, prong collars don't hurt dogs. They don't. And for all the fucking people that say they do, you're misinformed, you're lying, and you don't even need to have an asterisk if used properly. No. Even if you use a prong collar improperly, they still pretty much work. So, and guess what? Why would you use it improperly when there's free videos out there? I've got free videos. My colleagues have free videos. There's probably 100 good free videos out there on YouTube on how to properly size, put on, and start walking a dog on a prong collar. There's no reason for a person not to start walking proper on a prong collar. And when I see all these prong collars that are just dangling down like jewelry, you didn't watch the video. You didn't read the instructions. That's fine. You're not a bad person, but it's like, that's not how it's supposed to be used. But you're not going to hurt the dog that way. It just isn't going to be effective. So if you're struggling and you're walking, a minimum, get a prong collar. Next.
Marie, thank you so much for your videos. New German Shepherd puppy who is definitely keeping us on our toes. Need suggestions for puppy biting. Thanks.
Puppy biting is easy. Well, we didn't bring any bonkers in. Puppy biting is easy. So I work with puppies and they don't bite me. Why? Because the first of all, what does your day look like with a dog? If you have a puppy, it should be in a crate, like anything below 14 weeks old, 18 to 20 hours a day, it should be in a crate. Should be working on a ton of downtime. Not bad dog go in the crate. It's like you're a tiny puppy, go in the crate. I'm not gonna have you walking around my house. So I want you to do all food training, sit, down, place, tons of recall. Recall to sit, reward. Don't carry this damn dog around. I don't want anybody picking up this dog, right? Dog should be four on the floor. Dog bites you. And then also, don't have everybody loving on this dog. Everybody's getting the dog all riled up physically on the floor, and it bites them. What do you expect it to do? It's a puppy. So you've got to remember, you're training a dog, not a puppy. It's a dog. It just isn't a dog yet. So what I want you to do is, if it nips you, take your thumb, instantly take your thumb, boom, right in the back of the mouth, push down, make it suck. That usually stops it. If that doesn't work, get yourself a bonker. If you don't know what a bonker is, watch my video. Yes, you can bonk a puppy. No, it doesn't destroy the relationship. No, it won't make the dog afraid of you. You know what makes the dog afraid of you? Yelling at your dog all the time. Getting frustrated with your dog all the time. Everything should be methodical. I bonked 7 dogs today, all methodical. From a high, dry, biting, working line. Like, that dog's an ex-police dog. Mm-hmm. Ex-police dog. Mm-hmm. That dog freaking hit the ground when I bonked it. Mm-hmm. No.
Everything else ramped
it up. Yep, everything else ramped it up. That dog loves being corrected. 100, that's all you got, Gellman? Boom. I'll bite you for that. Hard leash correction, that's all you got? Boom, I'll bite you for that. Bonker, boom. On the ground, whatever you need me to do, Jeff, I'll do. Just like that. True. Guys, bonk the dog. And I'm very aware of the bullshit conversation out there about, you know, oh my God, blunt force trauma, brain injury, like from a cotton towel. What are people doing out there? What are people doing with these fucking bonkers? My God. Like, 90-pound pit bull runs through windows. Anyway, next.
Marvelous Maker. Have you guys ever heard of someone putting an e-collar on a farm cat? Tried putting my dog in avoidance, but the cat chases the dog when I do. Cat nearly got the dog in the eye.
Yeah.
I would.
I would. Why not?
Sounds like an ass.
Yep. Yeah, get a micro educator, put it on the cat, make it suck. They make underground fences for cats to keep them off the counter. Also, get a bonker. No, whiz it at the fucking cat. Absolutely. Get yourself a stockyard whip. Spank that cat right on the ass. I was going to say something sexual right now.
I knew it. So I was just like giggling in my head. Because I
knew you were gonna... You know what I'm going to say? Spank that. All right?
Yeah.
Got it? Next.
Rachel, dog only reacts to cats when they run, which makes it hard to do consistent training since cat in a crate has no effect. Any advice?
Correct.
Thank you.
Yeah. You got to get the cat. You got to find yourself some hunt for running cats and put your dog into avoidance. Make it suck to go after cats. Next.
Head to tail dog training, working with first real client tomorrow. Thanks for everything at T3, Jeff. 7-month-old dog has skin condition causing neck lesion. Mm-hmm. Prong might irritate depending on where it is. Slip leading to lesion heals?
I mean, you could, but you could also put a bandana on the dog and put the prong collar over the dog or go right to a remote collar. But also check, talk to them about proper diet. Talk to them about proper diet. Next.
Kim, 10-year-old Boston Terrier, fine playing with dogs his size and smaller, insecure with larger dogs. If the larger dog wants to play with him, he goes after them. Do I correct him or the larger dog?
Well, if you're in an off-leash area and it's for dog, if a larger dog literally comes across the street and goes after him, yeah, you correct, you kick the other dog, obviously. But if you're in a play group, there's a mutual understanding that dogs are there to play. So if a dog that happens to be bigger than your dog wants to come over and play, like it's, you know, and you're like, oh, no, stop here. Stop it. Nope. No. We don't play with the Jewish dogs, the Mexican dogs, the black dogs, or the big dogs. Okay? We're like, that's how we roll. Sorry. You can't come on my property and play with me. It doesn't work that way. So what you've got to do is correct your dog. Next.
Patty. Thought for a bit, wouldn't get on. Phew, new dog is doing well with the prong collar. One big issue, he's great when we go out the door together, but if I'm coming in, he gets past, took me on a tour.
What?
He's great when we go out the door together.
Yes.
But if I'm coming in, he gets past, took me on a tour.
What does past mean?
Got past her, like going into the house, I assume, and dragged her into the house.
Oh, okay. So what I want you to do is work on thresholds. So come to the front door, stop, default, do a threshold. It's a threshold exercise. Walk through the front door. The dog tries to get ahead of you. Make sure you catch it in the act when there's still the leash is slacked. Make it suck to rush through thresholds. Next.
Michelle, first time catching a live show. How do I work through human aggression? I do use the e-collar and it stops in the current instance, but then we are back to square one the next time around.
So I need multiple Skypes with you, not because I want to charge you multiple times. Human aggression is serious stuff. And it's not just about the remote collar. It's about everything. What is the 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, 365 days look like with that dog? I need a lot of information, which I can't get in this format right here. I need to be able to interact with you one-on-one. So if you're struggling with human aggression, which can end up with the dog being killed, I would encourage you to do a Skype. Now, if you don't want to do a Skype, you're going to have to figure out how to ask me like one question at a time, which if you fill up this feed, I cannot answer. It's not fair. It has to be, I want it to be a two-way face-to-face conversation because I need to recognize your tone. I need to see who I'm talking to when it comes to aggression rehab because I can read a lot from your body language, your facial expressions, your energy, because sometimes I don't believe the words, but I'm believing what I'm actually seeing, okay? So what you can start doing is right now, cut down on affection, make sure the dog is crated, make sure the dog is not guarding you, make sure the dog doesn't follow you around, all right? So place is big. Don't follow me around. Why? I don't want the dog resource guarding you. Next.
Ryan, any good sushi or pokey in Elkhart?
Pokey, no. Sushi, I'm sure there's some okay sushi, but I don't think we're going to go out for sushi. We could try tomorrow night, I guess. We're going to stay here tomorrow night. Usually Sunday nights, man, we used to leave Sunday nights after seminar. I've got a consulting gig here after the seminar. Plus, then we pack up the RV. By then, it's 7:38 at night, which is not late for us. But what am I going to do, drive an hour? It's not worth it. We're plugged in. We can go to the gym again, make sure we're all filled up with water. We'll just hit the road Monday morning. So maybe tomorrow night. We'll see. We'll talk about it next.
Lucy, happy early birthday, Joelle. Thanks, Lucy. Yep. That's so nice.
Joelle will be 25 on Monday.
Not like this Monday, though. I know. 13th.
I know. The 13th.
Well, that sounded like it was going to be like this Monday.
No, the 13th.
No. P. Gammon, loving the hair, Joelle. Your hair is cool also, Jeff. Congrats.
Oh, don't feel like you got to. You don't got to put me in the same compliment as her. She wants to be exclusively complimented. Okay. All compliments need to come in separate
Jeff
from her.
Jeff got his hair done on this trip.
Done?
Yeah. Yeah, you got it done.
Do you guys notice that my
hair? Yeah.
Do you guys notice
it's that? It's got like extra bounce to it. A couple inches taken off.
We have pedicures yesterday. Is it yesterday?
Yeah.
Yeah, yesterday.
And you got your hair done. Yeah. Your nails done.
I didn't get my fingernails. We got petties. None of us got manis, though. We got petties. No. Just petties.
Our hands are fucked up.
Yeah.
Go to the gym too much. Bobby, how do I work with my dog with her e-collar on when you go totally submissive and cowers on the ground?
I don't know what your e-collar skills are. I have no idea what your e-collar skills. That I mean, if your dog, you might be using the levels might be too high. You might not have conditioned your dog to the remote collar. I don't know if you're doing obedience or behavior modification. I have no idea. There's actually dog training involved with remote collars. And I say that, but I have no problem with people buying remote collars and doing the work themselves. But I want people to know, you still have to know how to train your dog. Because it's not about pushing buttons. The only time you push a button is to stop getting your dog out of the litter box, out of the trash can, fence fighting, counter surfing. You can use your e-collar there with no instructions. But teaching your dog obedience, you actually have to know how to train the dog, because it's all with food, markers, the remote collar, leash. You have to know the sequence of training in order to do it. When do you go to punishment? How do you proof? Do you prompt? How many times do you prompt before you go to correction? There's so many variables. So I don't know what you're doing with the remote collar. Next.
Pam, I don't even have to bonk. Just picking up the rolled up cotton towel corrects. We still have stuff that we can't fix, and I'm obviously not using the e-collar right, waiting for Vegas.
Okay. If you pick up that towel and you don't use it, that means you threaten the dog. If you pick up that towel, that means you should have used it. No, deploy. Got it? If your dog's doing something and you're picking up the towel, that's not how a bonker is. Not how a remote collar is either. People are doing that. People pick up water bottles to threaten their dogs. Pick up a remote collar saying, behave or I'll shock you. Behave or I'll bonk you. Nope. We don't do that. No, deploy. $5. Don't worry. In Vegas will be fun. $5 top chat. If you happen to find some Midwest sushi, one piece of nigiri on me. Actually, chances are that's probably two pieces, just to let you know. I do have caviar in the fridge.
Ugh. Those eggs. Did you guys see that? Weird. Crackers, at least.
Oh, so if I would have put the caviar in the crackers, you wouldn't be making a big fucking stink for 3 days?
Mm. No, it's weird to me.
I took a hard-boiled egg.
You put eggs on eggs.
I took a hard-boiled. You've obviously never been to any cocktail parties that serve caviar on eggs.
No, that's so weird to me.
Quail eggs especially. All right. Next.
Michelle. My other problem with her behavior when home alone. Sometimes she's great. Sometimes she chews things up. We would crate her, but she pees when left in there, and only if she is actually alone.
So you've got to start crating your dog and getting your dog through the pee. Shrink the crate by the width. Shrink the crate by the height so your dog can't stand up. Sounds mean. That's not forever. But we've got very specific protocols on separation anxiety. Okay? So that's what you're going to do. Monitor the food, monitor the water. Also, what's your duration work training look like during the day when you are there? Is your dog always active, or do you have your dog do place, not when it's tired, but when you want to? Next.
Patty, can you teach a male to go pee all at once? This is my first male.
Pee all at once?
Like instead of marking, I'm assuming.
Oh, yeah, of course. Next.
Kathleen, hey guys, great to be here. Looking forward to your seminar in Sharon Springs this fall.
Ooh, that's going to be a fun one.
Any tips on getting a dog to take treats easier?
Do you mean the dog's too rough? I would use the dog's daily food. We train with food, by the way. We use the dog's daily food. So what you do is you pretty much put it in your hand, and if the dog is rough with it, you say no and you bonk it. All right?
Good chat.
Oh, God, I get the hiccups. I never get hiccups.
I get them, like, on a daily basis.
Really?
They're so painful. I hate them.
But gosh. Remember when I cracked my rib, broke my rib, and I had hiccups?
This was here.
Yeah.
It's the first seminar I ever did.
Oh, right? Really? Oh, my gosh. I was in fucking pain.
Remember, I was supposed to fly, and then
this was
you're like, missed the flight. I can't drive.
I know. I paid for a flight for you, and we canceled it. We didn't cancel it. We just didn't show up for it. Yeah. You had to drive. I mean, I drove, but thank God.
I couldn't trust you. Oh, my God.
Did you document all that? Is that on our highlights?
It is.
That's on our highlight reel in Instagram. Guys, if you're not on our Instagram, IG stories.
That was a funny one.
A lot of fun stuff happens there. So IG stories on Instagram is a lot of fun. And it changes every 24 hours. It's new. So we're putting up, like, I think today we probably put up 20 or 30 little cells. Okay. And tonight, IGTV is going up. Newbie, $9.99 from Newbie 2015. Thank you, Newbie. Next.
Deb. Yay, staff. Great job.
Yes, damn right. Next.
Mm-hmm. Ginger Beaches of Hawaii. So excited for you guys to come to Oahu.
Yes.
Me too.
Yeah, me too.
Oh, another top chat.
$4.99, JP123. I've been using eCower and I only use between level 4 and 9, but every time I use it, he shakes his head. Does this mean the level I'm using is too high? No, not at all. And don't be worried about the level. I mean, what do you want the dog to be doing? I don't know what you want the dog to be doing. So he's just shaking his head because it's probably a new sensation. It's an irritant. So what I would do is I would teach commands on a leash, use a leash, and use food. Next.
Scarlett, I've been seeing incredible results from Raina and I've been documenting in IG stories. Thank you both for donating so much time helping people across the world and consequently helping other dogs.
Oh, awesome. Yeah, that's what we do. That's what my obligation is. I mean, I got a business to run too. We have to generate revenue, but 99.99% of the people that I'll ever meet will be on social media and it'll all be free shit. And I'm thrilled. I mean, I'm thrilled. I'm thrilled we can help so many people because of modern technology. And also, make sure you're tagging us in your Instagram stories because we'll repost it on our Instagram stories. We do that. Tonight, if you're watching the show, guys, videotape or take a photo of you watching the show. Like, probably those of you that are eating some caviar on eggs, have that out in front. Your dog's in place. Okay? And video, and then put it up and make sure you tag us. We'll put you up there.
Bananas and salad, caviar. What's next? Well, you do some other weird shit too with your rice pudding. You put like peanut butter in there. That's interesting.
David. So I have sometimes I have a late night snack.
So you know, you know those
little rice pudding cups? Like, you know those rice pudding cups? Okay, I get a rice pudding cup. I take a little spoonful off the top so it has some room to it now. I take some raisins. I put raisins on top. And then I take a spoon. I dip it in peanut butter. And then I use that spoon to eat the rice pudding. What's so weird about that? Should we really get into your fucking food protocols?
What are mine?
I don't
just weigh and measure everything.
I don't disclose personal shit here.
You can tell people what I eat.
No, I know.
I post it on stories.
No, I'm not gonna get into your nuances.
Okay. It's fine.
Next.
Damon, separation anxiety. He's really good and calm, not fixed yet when we're home. He even kennels willingly, but when we leave, he cries and whines and uses the bathroom in the cage.
Okay. It's not neutering won't fix that. So de-sexing the dog will keep the dog from procreating, not from separation anxiety. Almost 100% of the dogs that we work with that have separation anxiety, and it's a lot of them, have been de-sexed. So that didn't work. And many of them piss and shit in the crate. So it's not connected. Watch my video on separation anxiety on YouTube. Next.
Megan Reynolds, I do have them all back tied. I just meant I may have to take my attention off my dog I'm working with to correct the whining dog or the one in the process of breaking place. I guess just wait until they're more advanced.
Yeah, work within your comfort level. I don't know your skill set, but work within your comfort level. Next.
Aunt Girl 89 said hi to Jeff, but not to you, Joelle. Sorry. Hi. That's okay. Hi, Aunt Girl. Head to tail dog training. What kind of place duration should be expected from a 7-month-old dog? Dog's owner also says he only eats once a day, sometimes every 2 days. Okay to use some higher value food rewards to work him?
If you want to. I mean, a 7-month-old dog all depends on how long you've been doing place. So I would say 4 hours, but not if you just started it last week. But there's no reason why a 7-month-old dog can't to place for a couple of hours easily. But that all depends on how long you've been working on it. Next.
Megan, any experience with the Herm Springer prong with the buckle, not the quick release, but it's a buckle like a collar?
Yeah, I know what it looks like.
I have an older couple who struggles to open the prongs.
I'm not a big fan of those, but if it makes their life easier, then go ahead. Next.
Clink, Compton, my dog is now fear reactive and becoming dog aggressive. I correct him for no recall when he freezes just before charging the fence. No longer trust dogs since being attacked. What protocol do I do?
That's a lot. That's a multi-layered protocol. So the first thing we need to do is not have your dog, what is he, fear reactive? He's reacting to
other dogs.
To other dogs on walks.
He charges the fence. Sounds like he fence bites.
Oh, if he charges the fence, you just make it suck. So first step is make it suck to do that. Okay, we can't have a dog charging the fence. And the dog's not charging the fence necessarily out of fear, because if he was afraid, he would run away from you instead of run towards the fence. I mean, run away from the fence instead of run towards the fence. Best thing you can start doing is advocating for your dog. Keep the dog in a proper heel. Get your dog exposed to balanced dogs. Don't let dogs rush the dog. And just have, it's called flooding with guidance. Have your dog around lots of dogs, but keeping them away and keeping your dog in a heel, showing your dog that it can be around dogs without exploding. Next.
Kristen, I freaking love to hear that. The bonker works.
Yeah. Damn right it does. Next.
Pandora. Hey, Jeff and Joelle. No question tonight, but wanted to say how much I appreciate all you do. Hope you come to Northwestern Alberta.
I've got Vancouver and I've got Collingwood scheduled for 2019. Next.
Patty, I must say I giggle every time you say bonk the dog.
Yes, I know.
Jay, if you had a dog be leash reactive in a public space, would you correct on a prong in that, or do you reserve that for seminars and the training center?
No.
Are you at all concerned with public perception?
Who asked that question?
Jay.
Hamlin. Jay?
Hamlin.
Jay Hamlin. Do you really think I care about public perception? Me? No. I have an obligation to the dog. No, I correct a leash reactive dog wherever I am. You have to. You have to. It's the real world. We're training dogs at the center so they do well in the real world. If they don't do well in the real world, you've got to correct them in the real world. No, this is for real life. We train for the real world. But if the dog makes a bad choice, which they do because they're dogs, we correct them in the real world. I'd rather use a remote collar. It's more effective. But no, dogs get corrected out in public. Absolutely. Heel tap, chest tap, prong collar, remote collar. The only thing we don't do in public is bark. Next.
Ryan, do you think pit bulls are born dangerous or is it the owners?
Neither. It's just an outright fucking blatant lie. There's no such thing as that. Nope. And when you're saying owners, this is the problem when you're saying owners, and I'm not mad at you. At all. Like, I'm not mad at you at all. But this is the problem when...
Did I hit the wire?
Yeah, you're hitting the wire. It's okay. I'm not upset. I'm just like, watch where your feet are obviously in a line with the wire. And, oh, they can't go there because the bag's in the way. I see what's happening. Mm-hmm. Okay. So, it's just tipping over that way. This is the thing. When people say it's the owners, usually this is what people are implying. The owners were mean to the dog. When people say the dog is aggressive because of the owners, what they're implying is the owners mistreated the dog. That's what usually people go to. You know what I think? The owners gave the dog too much love and not enough boundaries. So do owners make dogs aggressive? Yes, they do, but not by being mean, not by being abusive, literally by not holding the dog accountable for bad behaviors. That's how they do it. But it's not a pit bull thing at all. It's a dog thing. So if anyone thinks that, oh, dogs, pit bulls are more inherently aggressive, that's just a lie. It's a blatant lie. Next. 1499, JP123, are you coming to Maryland for seminar near future by any chance? I was just there. I was in Frederick, Maryland, I don't know, 4 months ago maybe? 4 months ago. I was just in New Jersey. Two hours away from Maryland. I'm going to be in, and there's no more Maryland scheduled for 2019. But if you're in Maryland, you're close to a lot of things that I'm doing. Like if you're in Maryland, I'm going to be in Providence is close to Maryland. What else is close to Maryland? Go to jeffgellmanseminars.com. But your Maryland is drivable to Providence. Next.
Shayna, Jeff, I'm nervous about GSD I brought to seminar in New Jersey. You told me he's sensitive, and I agree. But since I brought him back to his owner, he's been, for lack of a better word, depressed.
That's bullshit. Who's this? Who's asking the question?
Shayna?
No. Shayna, yeah. No, he's not depressed at all, Shayna.
That long coded
check. Yeah. If anything, he's calmer. Stop worrying about that dog. That dog is an easy dog. That dog was a very, very simple dog. So, I don't know your training style. I don't know your skill set. But all I know is that's such a sensitive dog. He's not depressed. There's no such thing. The dog, if anything, you eliminated some arousal. We eliminated some arousal, and now he's calmer. Next.
JP donated 99 cents.
Oh, thank you, JP. Yeah, we don't see any. It's ridiculous. If anything under $4.99, we don't see at the top chat, which I can't stand. It's like, please, why would you penalize somebody that donated a couple dollars? Next.
Kim, both dogs showing dominant behavior. Lab hovers over top of the Boston. Both peeing all over each other's pee. Lab gets vocal and intimidates the Boston. He reacts.
Okay. You need to kick both their butts. That doesn't mean you're literally kicking their butts. It means, what's your house look like? How much structure? Are we just sitting back observing and reacting to the bad behavior, or are we being proactive? Both dogs kenneled up. Not because they're bad, because that's proper leadership. Kennel up the dogs. Kennel at night. Kenneling when you're not home. Walk them structured. Okay? No pulling at all. Walk. No sniffing. No marking. No pulling. Sit down place. Hold them accountable. Okay? Cut down on affection. All that hovering, correct. It's a lifestyle. It's a lifestyle. Next. And that's just the beginning. I've got 30 other things you can be doing. Next.
Christina. Okay. This is three parts. Ready?
Christina.
What about a dog that cries when he sees other dogs? He cries, help. Okay. That wasn't so bad. And gets excited.
Okay. So that's just arousal. You eliminate arousal. Remote collar can do that. Leash pop can do that. Next.
Eldo, what would you pick, Jeff? Adopting an 8-month-old female Doberman or a corgi puppy? Which is easier to train behavior-wise?
Two way different breeds. Way different breeds. Right now, I wouldn't get a puppy. If you're asking me, I'd get the 8-month-old Doberman because I'm not interested in any puppy, no matter what the breed is. Next.
Tiffany, I'm working with a white doodle. Herm Sprenger is color.
Yep.
He's discoloring his coat, mm-hmm. Not a knockoff. You see this?
Yep.
I do see that.
Yeah, we see that on white dogs in general. Get yourself a Corrigan. Mm-hmm. Corrigan, nickel-free, allergy-free collar. Next.
Melissa posted the links to Skype.
Thank you, Melissa.
Newbie 2015. I have a 3.5-year-old GSD. Hates my teenager son. All friends that come visit will drop his crack ball and remove himself from the situation. Total fear, prong collar trained, and e-collar trained.
He removes himself from the situation?
Yeah.
Good. Excellent. That's a good choice. That's a really good choice. So how old is the dog?
3.5 years old.
3.5 years, good. I would do this. Company comes over, tell your dog to kennel up, lie down, observe the world go by. Tell all your sons, buddies and your son, just leave the dog alone. That's the safest thing. Your dog is literally saying to you, I'm uncomfortable, I'm out of here. You know what the other option is? What is that, German Shepherd? Mm-hmm. You know what the other option is? For the dog saying, hey, you little punk-ass kid, you get out of here. And how do dogs say that? Lunge, bark, bite. So the dog moving out of that is fine. So instead, what you do, help mediate that situation. Just be like, oh, company's coming over. Hey, dog, puppy, kennel up, lie down. Don't worry about anything. I got it covered. Okay? Also, if you have not subscribed to this channel, hit subscribe, hit your notification bells. All right? We're on every Monday, Wednesday, and Saturday nights, 8 p.m. for a 90-minute show. Monday nights are usually a one-hour show starting at 8:30. Next.
Sandra, May birthday girls rock. Mine is Tuesday, not 21. LOL, almost three times that.
Nice. That's okay.
25 though. Oh my quarter God. Of a century.
Oh my God.
I know. Oh my God.
You're still more than twice your age.
Ah, newbie 2015. May 13th was my dad's birthday. Happy birthday. Thank you. Brian, better not let PETA find out about the e-collar.
Brian, PETA is a hate group, not a dog advocacy group. And PETA is well aware about the e-collar. And PETA can go suck my dick. All right? Because PETA, all they are is hate. They're not an... I hope people understand that PETA is not an animal rights organization. That is not what PETA is. PETA is pretty damn close to a terrorist organization. And that's the fucking truth. Because their tactics are similar. But PETA is a hate group. They're using dogs as the Trojan horse to get public sympathy to raise money to project their hate. And the president of PETA, do some research on her. Research her. There's been documentaries made of her. Read the psychological, the public psychological profile of her. Pull their 501c3 reports. It's a Virginia-based corporation. It's a nonprofit. It's public access. Pull it. You'll find out that they kill 98% of the animals that they come in contact with. All these people that supposedly love animals, they kill. They admit killing. It's on the report. They say they do. Not me. They do. On a government document, they admit to killing 98% of the dogs that come into their hands. They're not an animal rights organization at all. They don't care about animals whatsoever. Not one bit do they care about animals. That's their Trojan horse, guys. That's their Trojan horse. People need to understand that. And people are donating money to PETA? Sorry. You ain't helping animals any. None at all. All you're doing is funding the circle of hate. You're just funding the circle of hate. Next.
Christina, are you getting the questions from here? Yep.
Yeah, Christina. Yeah, Christina, we've been reading this for 50 minutes. We've been reading questions. Next. Yeah, Joelle's looking at her phone.
Yeah.
She's looking at the show on her phone. I'm looking at a laptop. Next.
Newbie 2015. He's been trained by Double H Canine Academy as well. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Kristen, no. 2 seconds, then bonk, or right away?
No. Bonk. Next.
Yeah. We're trying to teach calm around approaching people. We can pass just fine, but as soon as someone comes up, he loses it in excitement. Bonking and prong correction haven't resolved the issue.
There's too much arousal. The timing most likely is, the timing on that is most likely too late. You bonk at the first sign of arousal. So what I would start doing is right now I would be doing teach the dog how to remote collar heel, start advocating for a little bit of spatial pressure, move away a little bit. Also, that you can do a quicker food protocol, which is harder to describe on this. There's a lot of protocols you can do. But then also, can your dog do calming exercises around high levels of distraction in other situations? Next. Like long downstays in place. Next.
Emily, vet told me a dog doesn't always show signs before it bites.
Then that's a stupid vet.
I'm not done yet.
Sorry.
Think this is true, or is she just missing the signs? Asking lots of trainers to hear opinions.
Okay. Well, if you ask too many trainers, you're going to get too many different opinions. So if you talk to a trainer that rehabs aggressive dogs, that's worked with many of them, and many of them that supposedly have missing signs but was able to identify the sign, you'll know that a dog always shows a sign. Always. Unless... we're not talking about a dog that's in a sound sleep, wakes up and bites. That's not what we're talking about. We're not talking about a dog with a brain tumor, which most don't have. A dog always gives a tell. Always. And I can see it all the time. I'm never surprised. I'm like, yep, 3, 2, 1, bite. If I would let it go, there'd be a bite. But I don't. Why? I stop it hard. Always can tell. There's always a tell. Next.
Angela, are there any instances that you'd recommend euthanizing a newly dog aggressive dog?
Newly dog aggressive? No. Do I recommend euthanizing dogs? Only after I've worked with them and I established the rehabilitation process, and can they be safe enough for the family? And then I've got different guidelines on safety risks. So if a dog is aggressive towards its owners, that's a hard one. It's hard to own a dog that's aggressive towards its immediate family. So any kids in the family or any dogs in the family, or the adults in the family, the handlers. That's a hard one. You need to have safe dogs in your house. But if the dog is aggressive towards strangers, we can keep that dog alive. Towards other dogs, we can keep that dog alive. Next.
Crixis. Hi, guys. My mom was old school Italian. I wish she used the bonker on me when I was young.
Yeah.
Have a safe trip home. Me too, Crixis. I learned the hard way.
Okay. A bonker. A bonker would have been like a tickle.
Yeah.
A tickle.
For real. Shayna. He wasn't happy to see the owner. He only wanted to stay in the travel crate. I went there today. He was happy to see me, but I could tell he's off. So I brought him back to my house to see what's going on. Any thoughts?
Yeah, you shouldn't have brought him back to your house. Bring him back to the owner. He's not off. How's he doing with the owner? Shayna, again, I don't know your skill set. I don't know. I didn't watch you train. I didn't watch you train at all. I don't know the situation. All I know is the dog most likely is fine. Train the owners. Next.
Top chat.
Is that true? Bonky makes a dog hand shy? I've never said it. So did you hear that from somebody that actually knows how to bonk a dog and is successful thousands of times? Or did you hear that from somebody who did it wrong or has never done it before? And it's an imagined supposed. I heard. And then it just gets repeated like the fucking can game. You know what I mean? Like talking into the can with a string. So, no, it's not true. I've bonked so many dogs, and dogs are fine with my hands. Dogs are fine with the bonker. Because I show it all the time. I wave a bonker around my dogs all the time. I throw a bonker. My dogs barely move. If I say no and bonk, there you go. So that means somebody did it wrong. Or you're hearing that because that's one more lie about the bonker from people that have never actually used it, that are trying to sway others from not using it. Meanwhile, the bonker is probably one of the most successful tools out there right now that anybody can use to stop an unwanted behavior. Everybody has access to a towel. Everybody has access to rubber bands. Nobody can say they don't have the money for buying it. And nobody can say they don't know how to use it because there's free videos showing it. And so many owners are struggling. So many owners are struggling. Every day I get comments like, ask the next question.
Okay. So, Newbie 2015, please see my questions. I forgot to do money with questions about 6 minutes ago. I think we got to them.
Guys, we're answering every question. They just go in line. We're probably 30, 40, 50 questions behind. You have to remember how many questions there is. Okay, here we go. Ready. JP123. I watched your video and decided to use the bonker because my 9-month-old lab won't stop nipping, jumping, and barking. I try to stop those behaviors with all different methods on YouTube. Oh, shit. With all the other methods on YouTube, and none of them worked. Then I watched your video, made the bonker, and I didn't even hit him on the head. I just threw it on the floor and problem fixed in seconds. I can't thank you enough. I feel like all the trainers give me some bullshit methods. Well, we don't have to go, we don't have to read into that. But it's like, people are doing the work and they can't stop it. They make a bonker. The guy missed the dog. He threw it, he missed the dog, and it still stopped everything. One of thousands of pieces of feedback that I get on the bonker. I'm sorry. People can hate it as much as they want to. But those of the those of you out there that have been successful with it and seen how quickly it let me just fix the camera for your hands.
Okay, I'll just stop leaning.
Well, you can lean, but I'll just move the camera. There you go. Lean all you want now. There you go. They'll see it next.
Emily, I disagreed, and she told me I was just young. I've never seen it personally. I think there's always signs.
Yeah. You're young, so what? Young people, that doesn't mean you don't know anything.
Next.
That's a common thing. Oh, you're young. Mm. Next. Right. Mm. Yep. You're young. So what do you know? You tell that to fucking Zuckerberg. Okay. When he designed Facebook, he was young. Tell that to Elon Musk. When he started designing his first stuff, he was young. Next. All these people like young.
Condescending.
Yep.
Melissa said they will get to it. Newbie 2015. Yep. Yes, we will.
Yeah. We're getting to all of them, guys.
Shayna, by the way, Joelle, you are a gem, an absolute Wonder Woman. I think Jeff would be lost without you.
Shayna. So, for FYI, I'm 53 years old.
Yeah, you made it this far.
Okay, I've been in business for a long time. I've trained 7,000 dogs. Joelle's been my life for 6 months. I did fine without her.
Longer than 6 months, thank you. Like eight.
8 months. I did fine without her. But since Joelle has become part of the company, I'm loving every minute of it. We're able to do more stuff. All my ideas now can start coming to fruition because I have a like-minded person who has the same work ethic and drive as I do and has no problems working 18 to 20 hours a day nonstop. And I've got somebody that absolutely, so I've done 125 of these seminars on my own. People have loved them. Now Joelle's doing them. And yes, they're awesome. I'm not discounting her. So, but I wouldn't be lost. I wouldn't be lost. Not to discredit her. Her work is phenomenal. Phenomenal. Next.
Hold on, dog training. Hey, Ashley. Happy Saturday night. Enjoyed our Skype this week. Thanks for the guidance.
My pleasure, Ashley.
She also has a new goal to work towards for May.
You're going to quit smoking?
I passed the message along.
Did you?
I did. KK. So my German Shepherd puppy has done so much better when we let her off the chain, but when we take her for walks, she pulls bad, like she can drag me. Do you think a choke collar would work?
No. A choke collar will choke your dog. A choke collar would be the worst thing. Get a proper prong collar. There's a huge difference between choke collars and prong collars. The haters don't know that, but there's a huge difference. Next.
Kinsey, laughing emojis. You guys are the best. Weird eating habits and all. There's nothing weird about it.
There's nothing weird about
Trust
it.
Trust me, if I wasn't tracking my macros right now, I'd be eating rice pudding and peanut butter. And everything else you could imagine. Every night I'm a little envious. I'm like, damn.
See, that's what it boils down to. See, what it boils down to is, if I can't eat it.
I want rice pudding and peanut butter.
If I can't eat it, I'm just going to make fun of Jeff for eating it. Because maybe then he'll feel bad and he won't eat it too.
Starve with me. Oh,
sweet. Nope. So it's funny because there's private sleeping areas, thank God, in this RV. But the refrigerator is in the main
area.
So if I get up at, like, I don't know, 1 a.m, I'm like, I think I'm gonna have some rice pudding. Like,
I wake up to a pin drop. I'm like, what's he eating? I'm hungry too.
Maybe he'll drop some scraps.
I helped train my first dog the other day. We worked on the prong collar heel. Blew their mind.
Good. Proud of you.
Nice. Next. Kathleen, thank you, Jeff. I will try that now. The Sharon seminar.
Sure,
it's going to be great. It's only 20 minutes from me, so I thought it was meant to be. What can one expect as soon as you walk in? Thank you, guys.
A fucking shit show. Dogs.
But it's like organized.
It's an organized. So here's a good example. This one, there's only about, what, 15 dogs at?
No,
it's
sold out, I thought. So it's probably like 17.
I don't know. Anyway, usually there's up to 20 dogs. So what can you do? You got 20 dogs with nervous handlers with dogs that are leash reactive, dog aggressive, human aggressive. They come in pulling, jumping, barking. By 9:20, they're in their crates, quiet.
Today was actually 9:10.
I looked at the clock. Every dog, all in a row, literally all lined up in a row. No dividers, no separation, all lined up. Sometimes crates touching each other. It's a bigger room, this room, so we can have about, I don't know, a meter or half a meter in between each one. And guess what? Every one of them is quiet. Like that. Today, four dogs learned how to be quiet with a remote collar in seconds, and they've never had a remote collar on before. You videotaped a lot of that, right? Mm-hmm. That we gotta fucking put that up.
A little montage.
That's so important that people see that, and I'll do an overdub on that. Okay. Yeah. Next.
Canadian, how long do you normally condition a dog to an e-collar before just using corrections for breaking command? Oh. Why is the whole RV moving? Are the dogs itching or something?
Dogs are probably scratching.
Oh my god! It's like, whoa! Wait.
Somebody having sex up on the roof?
What? What's going on?
Hold on here. So it's not about conditioning the dog to the remote collar before you correct it for obedience. It's about training the dog on the remote collar before you correct it for obedience. So you have to first obedience train it. Next.
Josue, then I referred them to your videos. It felt amazing, impacting a life.
Josue, that's why I do what I do, buddy. Thank you. Proud of you.
Next. Emily, any stories of unicorn dogs that had specific issues you've never seen before or very rare issues? Story time, all these behavior issues are just so common.
I've never been surprised by a dog. I've worked with so many dogs with so many behaviors, I'm not surprised. I just don't get surprised. So, I mean, there are some unique situations, like, I don't know. I guess I should have not said that because now I can't think of one. Can you think of something?
Of what? Something we've never seen before?
Yeah.
We haven't seen it yet.
Yeah.
So I don't know.
Yeah, I literally have seen every bad behavior a dog could do. I mean,
I don't think there's ever been a day where me and Britt are like, never seen that before.
Yeah. I mean, at these seminars when there's 20 dogs, and that means we're going to see 500 dogs at our seminars this year. And none of them are going to surprise me. But see, this is the thing, though. Somebody's small problem is what you think is a small problem is a huge problem for them. When you have a dog that you can't take out in public, that's a humongous problem. Mm-hmm. Easy for me to fix, big deal. I've got a skill set. Now I've got to get the owner to be able to do it. That's the mastery of all of this. But today, you know what we did today? But today by, when do we bring all the dogs out today? 2 o'clock.
Early. Like this is like the earliest.
At 2 o'clock today, we had every single dog. Did you post photos of that yet? We'll get them up today or tonight or tomorrow. Maybe we'll post up one photo. Yeah. We had all 20 dogs out together in a circle. All 20 dogs in a space that's probably, I don't know, 5 to 7 meters wide, 15 to 20 meters long, maybe.
They're pretty close.
And they were all with their handlers, all lying. And then we had them all walk around past each other. Yep. Really? Yeah. Next.
Etho, I have 11-month-old male Alaskan Malamute. He heals nicely on walks, off-leash trained. When he sees another dog on walks, he will whine but do nothing. Should I punish the whining?
Play around with that a little bit. See what the remote collar does. See what the remote collar does. That's first of all, impressive. Congratulations. Anybody that has an 11-month-old dog that's doing off-leash healing has put some fucking work in. So kudos to you. Very impressed. Next.
Ellie bonked my 9-pound cat with a washcloth bonker, jumping on counters, and man, that shit works on cats too. Have a great night, y'all.
Washcloth? I would have fucking thrown a goddamn full-size bonker at that damn cat. But good for you. $5 chat. Kathleen, oh my god, you guys are too funny. That makes me feel better. I'm bringing my leash reactive boy. Thank you guys. Okay, so Kathleen, okay, let me just tell you something. Okay. Most of these dogs, I should say most of these dogs, usually every seminar, I'm the one they try to bite. Like, we have dogs that try to bite me in my seminars. So, if you're going to bite someone at a seminar, it better be me, first of all. That's, like, the game plan. But no, your leash reactive dog will be a cupcake, a pure cupcake. Next.
Shayna, the Russian way of eating caviar is to put chopped hard-boiled egg into the caviar and serve on toast points. I bought my ticket for the Rhode Island seminar. We can sit and enjoy together. See, okay.
Stop.
I could see it on toast. Crackers.
Stop. Oh, now there's a disclaimer?
There needs to be some crunch. You know how I am with texture? I can't do mushy, squishy things on other
things. Hold on. Okay. How you are with texture. What does that have to do with my eating habits?
Nothing, I guess. I was saying.
Did I make, okay, first
toast
of all.
Toast or crackers okay, with
me. But for, there's a couple of things here. First of all, did I make that meal for you?
No.
So why do you care?
I don't.
Yes, you do, because you haven't fucking stopped talking about it.
Everyone else is talking about the damn caviar.
You brought it up.
Okay. Whatever, Jeff.
Don't whatever and give me the hand. You brought it up.
Yep.
Lex.
Eat it with some freaking toast, would you? Karen GSC lover. Good evening. I have a Hertzsprunger with a buckle clasp. Could you explain why you're not a fan of those? Does it prohibit the collar from working correctly? Thanks.
Okay. If your dog has a wide enough neck, it doesn't affect it as much. The buckle clasp, sometimes you lose enough room that two prongs would sit there. And on some dogs, that you need those extra two prongs. That's why. But if it's working well for you, keep doing it. Next.
Abbas, hi guys, how are you doing? In your experience training Rottweilers, did you find them harder to train than other dog breeds, especially with dominant males, and do you recommend getting one as my first dog?
I believe Rottweilers can be actually a quite easy dog to train, actually, but depends on the genetics of the dog and the breeding of the dog. So, because it's like German Shepherds. German Shepherds, to me, are easy to train, but that's probably one of the more misbred dogs that are struggling with some psychological issues and health issues. So some of them are struggling on the learning curve. But as far as a Rottie, you know, I wouldn't recommend you getting a dominant dog as your first dog in general. Next.
It just booted me off. Sorry. So I have to get back on.
Okay. Cause I haven't been following.
Oh my God. I don't know. Is this the old one? Sorry, guys. YouTube booted me.
Did it? Oh, shoot. I'm like probably... I haven't been following because so I can look at the camera better.
Okay.
I don't know what else to... Where are we here? A four-month-old German Shepherd puppy with sudden fear around things he didn't used to be. Okay. Sorry, guys.
All right. Here we are.
Got it. Okay.
Melissa posted the link to the seminars.
Okay, next.
Charisse. Owners make dogs aggressive because of their ignorance.
Say that one more time.
Owners make dogs aggressive because of their ignorance.
Owners make dogs. Yes and no.
They don't know that they're training
it. I don't think owners are doing it on purpose.
No.
They just don't know. And
I don't think she meant that in like a bad way. Like ignorance. Like they just don't know.
They just don't know. And there are also so many false messages out there and so much false information online that I understand why. Next.
School of Science, 1878. I know who people who made their dogs so overprotective that the dog has become dangerous.
Yep.
I think people need to realize that dogs are dogs and are not little children, but people will never listen.
Well, that's not true. I have a different outlook on people in life, but that's fine. I mean, that's obviously your opinion and your comment, and you're entitled to it, and that's okay. But that's got nothing. If they make their dogs so overprotective, it's not because they compared it to a human. It's because they just didn't know how to stop it. A lot of times people just don't know how to stop things. People have to remember that I honestly don't think that people go, you know what? I want my dog to be a danger to society. I don't think people say, I want to mess up my dog so much that I've got to spend $4,000 at solid canine training. I don't think people think, you know what? I want my dog to bite my kids. Or bite my cousins, or I want my dog to redirect on me. I don't think they want that. Now, yes, some of their actions or inactions are leading up to that, but that's why I yell and scream so much and put out so much free content because I'm looking at things differently. So I'm like, to me, that's all a scream for help from everybody. And I'm willing to put that information out there. And is unpolitically correct as it sounds, and is, you know, it doesn't always sound like fun and hugs and kisses and rainbows, but geez, I wish that worked, because if it did, that's what we would be doing. Next.
Top chat,
$9.99. Guys, where can I give testimony about how great the seminar is and how effective the corrections are? So many people are questioning. I want to tell them it works.
Great.
So just message us. Just message us. Get a hold of, just go to my website. There's a contact form. Just fill it out there and Joelle will take care of it. Next.
Jay says, I did correct firmly. Caught some flack for it is all. Happy to know you're not bonking dogs in public, only in private.
Yeah, bonking is different. It's hard to do that in public. I mean, I do it in public in my seminars. If I'm outside in a seminar, I'll do it. Next.
Emily, pure positive people ever write bad reviews on Solid Canine. How do you respond or remove?
Emily, I probably get more hate than anybody in the fucking industry. I never respond. Ever respond. And it's not pure positive people, it's mean people. Have you ever heard me? I mean, I got a big fucking mouth. I never, ever, 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 ever respond to hate. Ever. So this is the thing. If it's a review, you can have that. First of all, nobody gives a shit about your reviews. So Yelp reviews, Google reviews, they're bullshit. Everybody knows they're bullshit. Everybody knows that you got to pay to play on Yelp. Yelp will tell you you don't. Let me tell you, you do. Yelp makes you pay to play. They'll come up with a bullshit excuse. They'll say, no, they don't, but yes, they will. And you can pay to get your bad reviews. Pay them. Now, a review, though, the person leaving a bad review, if they did not use your service, okay, that does break. That's not what a review on Yelp is. A Yelp is not for opinions. It's a review of the services rendered. If they didn't render, if you didn't render your service, they can't. That can be removed. But I don't give a flying fuck about any of that stuff. Do you know how many hate videos are there about me? Like, there's hate videos out of there. Like, just Google my name on YouTube. You'll see a lot of fucking nasty shit about me. A ton of stuff about me. I don't care. Oh, well. For some reason, every one of my seminars keeps selling out. For some reason, I keep touring the world. For some reason, people keep calling us up. And yet, people have to remember, most people don't care about any of that stuff, and they don't see it. They don't see it. So, but God, yeah, of course people like, man, I get on the UK. The UK's got the most hate in it. And you get on some of these UK forums. I mean, you don't go on them, but your name, you'll wake up to 600 fucking negative reviews. You'll wake up to 250 one-star reviews on your Facebook page. Oh, they fucking have it. The most organized, hateful country I've ever seen is the UK. Next. And none of it, guys, none of it matters. Okay.
Here we go.
I fucking love hate. I mean, I really love hate. Let me tell you a story. I got so many stories about hate. I make so much fucking money from hate. So much money. I'll give two examples. The last T3 that we did, it's a one-week seminar I do with my buddy Sean O'Shea and Tori Smith. It's a one-week, $4,000 seminar for 1 week. Now, three people that were at that one seminar, three people all at the same seminar, all found us through the same video attacking me. They saw a video of somebody attacking me hatefully. They found out who I was. Because they found out who I was, they start following my content. Because they followed my content, they realized the truth, and they realized that I could help them with business, training, social media, client relations, personal growth. They all signed up for my seminar. three people, $4,000. You guys do the math. One example. That's not a fluke. It happens all the time. Never three at one seminar. Usually at least one. Okay? I don't know what the ROI on hate is. I don't know it. All I know is it's good. Next example. Ready? Next example. I've got a seminar coming up. A woman emails me. Hey, Jeff, how are you? I'd like to schedule a Skype. I found you, ironically, I found you through a trainer who was bashing you. Didn't know who I was. She didn't know who Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training was. So what does she do? She's on one of her forums. Someone is bashing me. Who is this guy? Goes to my page. Goes, holy shit. Like, none of you fucking assholes have been helping me with all your freaking shit. All you do is bash other people. This guy seems like he knows what he's talking about. Did a 1 hour Skype, $150. It's not about the money, guys. I do most of my stuff for free, but I want people to know I monetize the hell out of hates. $150. Wow, that was a great fucking Skype. I think I'm going to come to a seminar with my husband and bring my dog. $750. This is one story, two stories I'm sharing you. One story, because this person found me through hates, $900 in revenue from this one person has happened. That's one story. Guys, I love it when people take my content, post it on a forum, especially some of these big forums, and bash me. I truly love it. Why? I get seminar tickets sold, Skype sold. I monetize my YouTube videos. We're doing better on YouTube monetization than I ever have in the history of my company. This year, 2019, I'm getting more hate than ever, and I'm up 300% on my monetization of my videos. Bring it on. Keep hating. And I'm serious. It doesn't bother me. Guys, I'm on a fucking mission. I said, I'm looking to change the world. If you don't like what I have to say, I don't really care. I have no obligation to you. I'm here for the people that are interested in the message. That's all I care about. It won't stop me. Nothing will stop me. I've had investigative news reports done on me. I've had newspaper articles written about me. I've had bomb threats come into my company. I get death threats. I get a ton of anti-Semitic shit. I get all kinds of, what do I care? Bunch of weak, spineless people out there throwing hate at me because they got nothing fucking else to do. That's all you got. That's all you got is hate. I don't give a shit. Next.
Shit.
Sorry to take up so much time, guys.
Yeah, geez.
But this is the thing. I want my fellow colleagues to not be bothered by hate. Guys, love it. Never respond. Embrace it. Bring it on, baby. Let's go. Never argue. Never defend. Never reply. Ban and delete. Put up more videos. Next.
Clink. When my dog is trembling in a state of fear, an example, thunderstorms or in car driving on highway, what protocol do I use to calm him?
Put the dog into a down. Put the dog into a down. Help the dog process it. Next.
Aunt girl, Jeff, ever thought of doing a seminar here in Puerto Rico?
Sure.
Yeah, let's go.
Help me put it together, Aunt girl. I'm easy to get a hold of, not by phone, but by message. Next.
Kim, you missed my other explanation. Lab is a friend's dog we are watching. Follows Boston everywhere and hopes he will play. When he gets stiff, she hovers and he reacts.
Got it. So that you stop the following around. Stop the lab from following the Boston around. Next.
Amethyst, we started to use the same structure we use on our 5 month am staff on our 10-year-old chihuahua, and he's not such a problem anymore. We got him a cage too. No free roaming. We love you and your free info.
What do you know? Next.